everyone, and welcome to another vlog. This is going to be half pickup from the stuff I got while I was on vacation, or stuff that came in while I was on vacation. And then the latter half is going to be showing you my dad's Game of Thrones room, if you're a Game of Thrones fan. And also showing some of his retro gaming stuff. You follow me on Instagram, you know my dad used to have a huge collection, and he sold it all off. Well, he's buying again. He's gotten back into it, just picking up little stuff here and there, but it's starting to accumulate in some pretty cool stuff, especially box system. He's had a good run on box system. But we're going to get into that afterwards. For now, we're going to go through this whole pickup stuff. So if you're into that kind of stuff, you'll have that. If not, you can skip forward and find the end where I have all that. Also, I just want to say huge shout out to Joe Bleeps. He is letting me use some of his chiptune music for this video and other videos. So the entire time you'll be hearing his music, and there will be links in the descriptions for his Facebook page and his SoundCloud page, so you can join in on that kind of stuff. Without further ado, let's start. We're gonna start off with some random stuff first. This vinyl, Walt Disney Studios, Chilling Thrilling Sounds of the Haunted House. I don't collect a lot of vinyls, but I do like those random horror sound ones. And this is like the second one I've picked up. Super stoked for them, they're cool. I can't wait for Halloween so I can put them on and just sit here and stare at the camera. I'll make a video where I just listen to it and stare at the camera as awkwardly as possible. Another pretty random thing, growing up I was a huge Wizard of Oz fan. Love Wizard of Oz. And my dad actually found a bunch of Wizard of Oz toys that are from 1988, which is the year I was born, and also the 50th anniversary. I am missing one. I am missing the Scarecrow, but I do have Dorothy, the Lion, personal favorite of mine, the Witch, Glinda the Good Witch, and the Tin Man. Tis Man. So I got all those, and they're cool. They're neat. I like those. While I was on vacation, a buddy of mine, Gage, hit me up and was like, "Hey, I'm out Funko Pop hunting. Do you need any of the summer exclusives?" And I was like, "Yes, please. Let me get Mag the Mighty, Game of Thrones." I don't know why they did him instead of 1-1, because I figured 1-1 would be a more popular choice. But I'm still excited for him. I was really glad he hit me up and told me about him and picked it up for me. Whether you're collecting retro video games or collecting movies or collecting Funko Pops, that's what it's about. Hit your buddies up and be like, "Hey, I'm out looking. What do you need?" And he did. So I got this, and I got one for my dad, who he's getting close to having all of the Funko Pops for Game of Thrones. He's missing some of the exclusives, but for his birthday, I just gave him the Renly Baratheon Funko Pop, which, if you know anything about Game of Thrones Funko Pop, it's the rarest non-exclusive slash variant. So, pretty stoked for that. Let's get into some more randomness. Super Troopers for the PSP. Why not? Vampire Hunter D for the PS1. This is just disc and manual, but I was pretty stoked about this. I love Vampire Hunter D, one of my favorite animes, and I was super glad to get this. I've never played the game, so this will be fun. Also, speaking of Game of Thrones, the Telltale Games Game of Thrones for PS4, my dad was telling me this is amazing and I need to play it, and the podcast I listen to for Game of Thrones, they talk about playing it also, so I know I need to play it. So now I have it, now I can get playing it. Also, I got this Game of Thrones shirt while I was down there because it's awesome. 12 horror movies. I'm a big horror fan, as you'll see soon when we get to the VHS's I picked up, but it was 12, mostly terrible or weird ones. I don't know. None of these sound too familiar, but we'll all have to wait and see. Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3 for PS2, just because it's a Tony Hawk game and it was free, and I like Tony Hawk games. Book 4 of the Vampire Hunter D series, Tale of the Dead Town. Most people know the anime, but it actually started out as a book series. That's the fourth book. I've read the first three. Stephen King's Gunslinger, part of the Dark Tower series. This is the first book. I've never read it. The movie's coming out. It looks really interesting. I do enjoy Stephen King books. Eyes of the Dragon being my favorite and Salem's Lot being my second favorite, so I'll check that out. I know a lot of people so far are liking the way the movie looks, so hopefully it'll be good. While I was on vacation, the week before my vacation was G-Fest, which is the annual Godzilla convention. One year I will go to it, but I couldn't go to it this year, obviously, and Vampire Robots, who is who I buy my X-Plus figures from, vampirerobots.com, if you need some, like, seriously, I have, hopefully this won't be too loud, but literally, I just got this big boy, Space Godzilla X-Plus, the Diamond reissue from Vampire Robots, and if there was stuff on I'd pull, I have Titanosaurus right here also, that I recently got, but Vampire Robots is amazing. And they got a variant for Godzilla Oblivion that was for G-Fest. And luckily, they had some left over, and they put it on their websites, and I bought this up quickly. Because I love variant issues, I love Godzilla, I love Vampire Robots. I'm gonna trick him into marrying me one day so I can get free X-Plus figures. And then I got this issue of Nintendo Power. It is issue 162. The cool thing I want to bring up to this is it has its like Nintendo Power poster in the middle of it, like they all do somewhere. But this one, for some reason, okay, you see Godzilla, Destroy All Monsters, and then Godzilla, Destroy All Monsters. It has two posters in here, two of them. I don't know if it's a mess up just for this issue, if it was in all the issues that were like this, or not. So if you know, if you're copy this has two Godzilla posters in it, let me know. My buddy saw this and got it for me because I'm a huge Godzilla fan. He was like, he had to get that for me. He also got me this one, which is a PC gamer. I don't really do PC gaming that much, but it's got Doom on it, Doom 3. I didn't really like Doom 3, but I'll take it because it's Doom. I'll read through it. It's cool to read through. Okay. We've got three big things left. So we'll start with the VHS tapes. I picked up a bunch of VHS tapes. All of these except for one of them all came from, well, three of them. All but three of them came from my dad. So let's go through some of these. Dr. Giggles. I actually watched this movie as a kid. I have not seen it since. He had it and he said I could take some VHSs, so I grabbed it. I remember the scene where the needle goes through like the keyhole in the door, and so I'm gonna watch this. I'm gonna watch this again. I said it earlier, Salem's Lot's one of my favorite books by Stephen King. Well, here's the VHS. I liked this movie. I like the book more, but I enjoyed the movie. Friday the 13th, Part 7, The New Blood. Kane Hodder is in it. He's amazing as Jason. I love him. This is probably it's in top three for me. Like Jason, the first Friday the 13th is amazing. Part 4, the final chapter, is my all-time favorite. This is probably next in line. Okay, Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan for about 5 minutes in this movie. But other than that, it's a good movie. I enjoyed it. It's a pretty good one. Kane Hodder, once again, amazing. Cool thing about this, if you see that right there, the part of the cover for the movie is actually cut out because this is like an ex-rental. So it's in their rental plastic, which is neat. Halloween 3, Season of the Witch. A lot of people give this movie flat because it doesn't have Michael Myers. But go back and watch it as a movie called Season of the Witch. Drop the Halloween part. And my God, is this a good movie? This is just a super, super good movie. Oh, I want to watch it again now. Okay, we will continue with. Okay, so I told you there were three movies that I didn't get from my dad. Well, here's two of them. X-Men, Pride of the X-Men, which was like the first version of the cartoon they did. This was like their how they wanted to go with it. Luckily, they changed it because this isn't that great. They changed it, and it's good. And the other one is this one, Dragon Strike video. So this actually goes to the Dragon Strike board game, which they didn't have there. These both came from a Goodwill. But they had this VHS tape, and I was like, oh man, this is awesome. So I got it, and I plan on watching it. I've seen a review of Dragon Strike from Angry Video Game Nerd. So when I saw the video, I had to get it. Let's continue with a movie I've never seen. Alien Predators. There's no place to hide. I know nothing about this movie. I just saw it and was like, I don't know what this is. I'm going to get it. 1988. I don't know what it's going to be like, but it should be a fun watch, I guess. Another movie from my childhood I loved. House. I remember watching this with my grandfather, and there's a certain scene in there where, like, he cuts up one of the monsters and put it in a black trash bag and takes it out to the trash can to dump it, and there's a guy, I guess a neighbor, comes up and talks to him. The bag starts moving, and it's hilarious. If you haven't seen House, watch it, and that is an awesome cover. Now that's a horror hand right there. Amazing. From the chilling imagination of Clive Barker, Candyman. I've only seen this like maybe twice in my whole life, so I figure it's worth watching again, and I'm gonna check it out on VHS. Let's see here. What's next? You can't go wrong with Kaiju on VHS, so Rodan. I love Rodan. That's such a fun one, and I was pretty stoked to get this one, just because I actually have this cover, but I think my cover's in, like, really bad condition, so this will be a nice replacement copy. Dawn of the Dead. George Romero. You can't go wrong with Dawn of the Dead. Probably hailed as the best out of the three of his, like, original trilogy. So, I got it, and I like it because it's clamshell, and clamshell VHS means it's fancy. So, a movie that I watched growing up because I love creature features is Python. Terrible movie, but I loved it. Before, we had like tons of shark movies. They used to just do tons of snake movies because I guess making snake movies is a lot easier. So I got Python again. One of my favorite things I picked up VHS-wise. Is Shark Attack, and it's actually my childhood copy of Shark Attack. And Casper Van Dien is in both these movies, so he probably likes it. This is from Ingles for $10, and Ingles is a grocery store. There was one in Griffin, Georgia when I lived there and I was in elementary school. And my dad got this for me because I love Jaws, and so if it's a shark movie, I'm gonna watch it. Shark Attack 1 and 2 are pretty good. The other one's not so bad. Nowadays, you can find footage of people dying or getting hit by cars all over the place. They're all over YouTube, all over stuff. And even before that, you had like Rotten.com, if you remember that, you sicko. Before that, though, there was Faces of Death. This is Faces of Death Part 2, clamshell Gorgon release. It's pretty sweet because the Gorgon video does a lot of cool stuff. So this is that. Now it has come out that a lot of stuff, some of it was set up and fake, but there is still a lot of realistic stuff in there. Caution, the brutal and explicit depiction of actual death upsets you. Please do not view this film. Well, I viewed it when I was younger because my dad had it. Now I have it, haha. And the last VHS tape, probably the one I'm most excited for besides Shark Attack, is one that I did not get from my dad. I got this from my buddy Kenneth, who I do a horror podcast with him. Me and our buddy Jay, we do a horror podcast called Kill the Cast. And Kenneth has shown me a lot of horror movies in my time that I had never heard of or never seen. And one of those was Zombie, and it was this copy. This is his VHS copy of Zombie that he gave to me. Because I wanted it really bad, because we watched it together. I have it on Blu-ray, and the Blu-ray looks amazing. In fact, going from watching, I had only watched it on this VHS copy, going to that Blu-ray copy, blew my mind with how good they cleaned it up. So this is Zombie, Lucio Fulci Zombie on VHS. It has a reversible slip cover. And I was just stupid beyond excited for that. Okay, that clears out VHS tapes. We are going to do two toys before I get into the video game. So, let me bring these two guys up. We have Gamera and Space Godzilla. There is a story behind these two guys. My growing up, about my elementary school years, my dad was engaged to a woman, and her son, who lived with his grandparents, me and him got along really, really well. We were both really nerdy. Grew up playing, like, I had Pokemon Blue, he had Pokemon Red. But he was never really into, like, Godzilla or anything. I mean, as a kid, yeah, you like watching the monsters, but not like I was. And his mom at one time went to Japan and bought him these on her business trip to Japan. And every time I went over to his house, I would want to play with these. I've never actually seen them moving or walking because there was never any batteries to put in them. But they apparently move, make sound. I'm hoping these will like light up. I don't know yet. I'm going to look. Gamera is actually from 1995. Space Godzilla's from 94, they're both Bandai, and I can't wait to play these. And yes, these are his original ones. He brought them to me while I was on vacation. Billy, you're the man, thank you so much, let me get them ElfQuest. But these were awesome, and I am so stoked to have them and to put them into my collection. They are just amazing. Let me get these guys down, and we will get into our last part. Uh-oh, Gamera fell down. Don't fall down, Gamera. He's drunk. Okay, let's get into the last part. My buddy Kenneth, who I bought the, not bought, but who I got the zombie VHS tape from, he hit me up and was like, hey, I have a huge lot of video games. Do you want to buy them? And I'm like, yes, 100%. Now, I'm going to warn you right now. I'm not going to pay you retail, but I'm not going to give you like a super low ball offer that a reseller would give. I'll give you something fair that I feel is fair. He sent me pictures and I looked through everything and we came up with a good price. And now I want to go through everything I got. And if you're in retro gaming, you're probably into collecting, so you know the past couple of years prices have shot through the roof. It has been a lot harder to find lots for good deals. But I did, so let's talk about it. So first, two Game Boy Advances SPs. We have a 001 model and a 101 model, so the super good model plus the regular model. They both work. They're in okay condition. The screens are actually still really good. Three games come with that, plus this case, which has a charger, but no one cares about that. Castlevania, Circle of the Moon, which is amazing. Castlevania, Harmony of Dissonance. And when he told me the third game was Donkey Kong Country 3, I was like, cool, sweet. I'm cool with that. Whatever. I didn't really honestly care, even though I still need a Super Nintendo copy of this game, but it's a actual not for resale copy. This is a demo cart. On the back, it says not for resale, demo GPK only, property of Nintendo. Hopefully that's not looking terrible. I hope that's focusing correctly, but I've never owned a demo cart, not for resale cart, so this is awesome to have. I was super stoked about that. It's not like it's like crazy rare or worth tons of money. It's like 30 to 50 bucks, depending on condition, I guess. So yeah, now I can't get the thing to close properly. Cause I'm not only terrible at video games, I'm terrible at putting video games back in their cases, so that's just not going to go back in the case. But that's fine. Also, I picked up a working NES and a working Super Nintendo. A little bit of love, and I'll get these bad boys rolling. So, let's go through the games I got. Super Nintendo, Killer Instinct times 2, which is cool. Mortal Kombat. Midway Arcade's Greatest Hits, the Atari collection, so I'm guessing that's all. Is it arcade games, or is it Atari 2600 games, or is it Atari games that were made in the arcade? I will find out. Donkey Kong Country 2! Which is great. I love Donkey Kong Country 2. Street Fighter 2. Spawn. Which is hard. That is a horribly hard game. I should play that for Get Good. I would probably lose a lot. Super Mario World. Which came from a video game exchange from Daleville, Alabama. I don't think they, if I call them, I don't think they'll answer. Super Punch-Out, which I was super stoked for, because I don't have Super Punch-Out. Label kind of sucks, but you know what? At least I have the game and I can play it. Super Mario All-Stars. And last but not least, the Super Nintendo, two copies of Donkey Kong Country. I don't know why two copies of Donkey Kong Country. Two copies of Killer Instinct. Oops, I don't know if I can get this down now. But I'm super excited. Gives me some trade fodder. With some extra copies. So, let's go with NES. Legacy of the Wizard, which there was actually a couple manuals that came with this. Super Mario Bros. 3, Tiny Toons, Legacy of the Wizard, and a photocopied Friday the 13th one, which is Friday the 13th photocopied one on yellow paper. If you remember rental stores, you'll remember seeing stuff like this. I actually have a couple other photocopied manuals because I think they're neat because they're from rental stores, which no longer exist. Of course, there's Super Mario Duck Hunt, which when I was in Georgia, we went to this retro gaming store. They wanted $19.99 for a copy of Super Mario Brothers Duck Hunt. $20. I walked out of the store without buying anything because the prices were absurd. Absurd. Batman. I've done a Get Good on this, and I did terrible. I was really, really bad at it. Rambo. Which, just anytime I see Rambo now, it just reminds me of Keith Apicary, which is always great. Pinbox, which I like pinball games, so that's fun. Clash at Demonhead, which is one of my favorite NES games. I played it a lot as a kid. I talked about it in that top four video that I recently did. Castlevania 2, Simon's Quest. Okay, here we go. Super Mario Bros. 3, which you need for any NES. Friday the 13th. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. 1, 2, 3, which I'm super stoked for. I think number 2 has the best cover, because that cover, like, this one's a mean cover and all, and I like it and all, but this cover is so much fun. And then one more trilogy, Ninja Gaiden 1, Ninja Gaiden 2, Ninja Gaiden 3, always good. And speaking of this, if you're a fan of mine, you probably are a fan of John Blue Riggs. We'll have something cooking up soon that involves a certain game that maybe you can win. Mysterious. Also, like, I need to show this, because this is cool. It came with this, like, most of the NES games came in this, which my grandfather had a couple of these, and he still does. And he would put our favorite NES games in this, and my brother had one, and I had one, and this is where our favorite games were kept, and all the other games were kept up in the closet. So that's, I think that's it. The only other thing is, like, this is a Doom poster. I'm not going to unfold it, though. So that's pretty much it for all of this stuff. I'm going to now let it cut to all that other footage. Now.
How about some Game of Thrones action? And we do have some great, this is a Gaelic arcade, but it's actually one of those 401 ones. We've got some NFL Blitz. None of them are currently turned on. And back here, we have what is... There we go. A little bit of extra light. This right here is my dad's retro room. And there are some arcades, like a nice Sega Hang-On. We've got a MAME. This MAME's quite old. I think this one was built 10 years ago. Donkey Kong action. Then we have a Rygar machine, which is really, really nice. And a Centipede one he is working on. So that's the retro room that he has built up. It's pretty sweet. He actually sold everything last year and then started completely over. So he's now building back up. And you probably can't see any of it in here, but Laserdisc, wall of VHS. Just a huge, huge wall. I actually took a couple out of here, take home with me, which you'll see when I do my small pickup video. So yeah. Go back to that NFL Blitz. So that's his retro room, his Game of Thrones room. I showed you Famicom Twin System in another video. That'll be its own video. So this is just me kind of showing you things he has here. There's a Wild Reese. Let's film her for a bit.
Catching up on my stuff.
Catching up on stuff or catching Pokemon. One of the two.
Catching Pokemon.
Look at this. I don't know if you can see it. It's a vinyl that has all the house sigils cut into it, which is awesome. Nice picture there. He has tons of the books for the history and philosophy, card game, the card game expansions, trivia game, the Battle of Westeros game. We actually just got these, the Tyrion, the Daenerys, and the Jon Snow. They're like 20 bucks at Target. Fun stuff. The Risk board game, the Game of Thrones board game. Some of the books. All these magnets. And one of my favorite things, so these art pieces right here, like this one says, Sir Ilim, bring me his head. The Lancers send their regards. You know nothing, Jon Snow. My personal favorite, right here, I am your son. I will always be your son. I've always been your son, which I got this when I went to go see the last two episodes of season 4 in IMAX when they put them out there. So I got two. I got one for me and one for him. And I showed the banners. What I didn't show is the pillows. Sweet little King Rimley right there. And there's more right there. We got the Freys, Baelish, the Wall, and the Greyjoys. So, and then He's got some stuff in here. He's got a Retron 5 hooked up. He's got an Xbox running Coin Ops, which he just showed me. Coin Ops is awesome. I've got to get me an Xbox to mod now to do Coin Ops, because that was ridiculously awesome. Wii U, Xbox 360. You know, VCR, he's got a PC hooked up to this. It's pretty sweet.
This doll, he bought this doll off eBay because it looks like the one from episode 1. It's creepy. But he bought that, and that was pretty sweet.
And then there's a crow that hangs out right by the TV. And this right here, let me move Jon Snow out of the way. It's an art piece. I don't know who the artist is, but it's dedicated to the mountain, and it is actually signed by the mountain. I don't know if it's going to show up, but you can see the hand right there. It's actually signed by the mountain. So yeah, that's just a little bit of the Game of Thrones room and the retro room, and some other of his arcades and such. So there's another video that's going to be coming out that's going to show the Famicom Sharp Twin System and give a little bit more information about it. It'll probably be out before this video. So that's it. I'll see y'all next time.
And we're back. So now that you saw that other little tour, this is just going to be my ending. Here we go. Like, subscribe, comment, tell me what your favorite thing I picked up is. Did you see anything in those rooms that my dad had that you would want? Tell me games to play for Get Good, even though this is not a Get Good episode. Let me... How's the audio and video on this camera, except for those two segments at my dad's, because I use my old camera? I got a slightly better camera, just slightly, and I'm hoping the audio and video is better. Other than that, like, subscribe, share, comment, all that jazz. Hit up Joe Bleeps and listen to his chiptunes music. It was awesome. I mentioned John Blue Riggs. Go check out his channel just because. And other than that, that's all I have for you. This video had a little bit of everything. VHS, horror, Space Godzilla, Gamera, Kaiju, Game of Thrones, Wizard of Oz, video games, comic books. I just had about everything in this video. But that's okay. So... that's it, that's all I have for you, and I will see you next time on The Game Case, and check out my latest video, which was Get Good Gradius, because that was a lot of fun. Goodbye, everyone.